Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MongoDB server on a Windows operating system. And then I'm also going to show you about MongoDB shell, which is introduced on MongoDB version 6. And I'm also going to show you about MongoDB Compass. So this video is going to be a bit longer. So what I'll be recommending you is to, you know, to watch the video till the end so that you can get a complete overview of MongoDB, about MongoDB server, then MongoDB shell, and also MongoDB Compass. I'm going to also write, you know, how to create a database, how to create collection, how to, you know, delete, insert. I'm going to show you pretty much all of that. So, you know, watch the video till the end. Right. So first of all, you need to download the MongoDB server. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, just simply search with MongoDB download and hit enter. And you'll be getting this mongodb.com as our first search result. So here you need to just simply click on MongoDB community download. And this is going to redirect you to this official site of MongoDB. So you can see MongoDB community server is rightly over here. So if you just simply scroll down, you can see that our latest version of Mongo, that is MongoDB, you know, version 6.0.1 is rightly selected over here. So depending upon what operating system you are using, if you are using Windows, then you need to choose Windows from here, or if you are using, you know, some other operating system like macOS or, you know, Linux or any other Ubuntu or any other operating system, you need to select that operating system from this drop down. So that totally, you know, depending upon what operating system you are using. And from here, you can download this MSI one, which is basically the Microsoft installer. Right, so this is all already selected by default. Just simply click on download button and you can see it has directly started downloading our MongoDB. So by the time it gets installed, I'll also show you how to download MongoDB shell. So just, you know, simply open a new tab and type MongoDB shell download. Right, hit enter, and here first one is add, just simply skip that part. And then just simply click on this mongodb.com. You'll be seeing this domain. So just simply click on MongoDB shell download. And again, it's going to redirect you to this official site of MongoDB. See MongoDB shell. So just simply scroll down. You can see the current version. Our Windows platform is also selected. So it's pretty much same what I have showed you to download MongoDB. This time it is MongoDB shell. So just simply click on download. And it will going to start downloading our MongoDB shell as well. Okay, so that is Mongo SH. SH means shell. Okay, so see our MongoDB shell and MongoDB is rightly downloaded. So let's minimize our browser and go to our download directory. And you can see that our MongoDB is rightly downloaded along with MongoDB shell. Okay, so let's first install our MongoDB. So double click on our MongoDB installer. So here you can see our MongoDB installation wizard directly open. Just simply click on next. You know, check this license agreement. Just simply click on next. And here you need to click on complete installation. Okay. So here it is very important to select this install MongoDB as a service. So all it basically means is that our MongoDB will be, you know, installed in our service. So if you click on the search icon and here just simply search with service. I'm just going to give you a bit overview about service, Windows service. So see, these are all service installed, like whatever software I have installed on my machine. So these are all service are already installed. Okay, so all it basically mean is what I'll just minimize this service. So all it basically mean is they're going to install this MongoDB as a service in the backend. Okay, so that will, you know, automatically going to start running whenever you, you know, start our MongoDB. Okay, so that's a very important step. If you don't check this, every time you need to set this, you need to basically turn this service. Okay, so I'll be, you know, recommending don't do that. Just simply keep this default, so it will automatically going to start your service. So basically you can keep everything as a default. So I'll just simply give you an idea about what they're going to do. So they're going to, you know, create that data directory over here. And here going to be all log information. So everything that we are doing pretty much will be stored in our log, and here we'll store the data. Okay, and the service name is MongoDB. Okay, So just simply keep everything as a default. Do not, you know, tamper anything. Just simply click on next. And see, it also going to install our MongoDB Compass, which is totally fine. I'm going to, you know, demonstrate that as well in the latter part of the video. For now, just simply click on next. And see, it's ready to be installed. Just simply click on install. And there you go. Our installation has rightly started. But before installing, it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And our installation, see, is rightly started. So this installing MongoDB will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after completion of this process. Yep. So welcome back. And now as you can clearly see that our MongoDB is rightly installed and our Compass is also, you know, open. See MongoDB Compass. So our Compass is also open. So just simply click on finish. So see, our Compass is rightly open. I'm going to give you a detailed overview about MongoDB Compass, but before that we need to finish a couple of steps. So let's minimize this. And what you need to do is you need to first extract this MongoDB shell, which is also, you know, very important. So just simply click on extract all and extract. And after, you know, it get finished extraction, you can see this, you know, Mongo sh is rightly extracted. So if you go inside that folder, you can see all files and folders rightly over here. So let's go back our directory and let's, you know, rename this to just MongoDB and then the version number. I'll remove the other part. Okay, so I'll just shortening the folder name, and what I'll be doing is I'll be just simply cut this, you know, the extraction of the MongoDB shell, and then I'll just simply go to my C drive. I'll right click and I'll just simply paste that. Okay, so our MongoDB shell is rightly pasted over here. Okay, and now two very important step. First is you need to go to your Mongo shell and go to bin. So just simply, you know, click on this environment path and copy. So you need to set environment variables. So click on the search icon and just simply type with environ. And you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just simply open that, click on environment variables, and here under system variables, you need to just simply click on path and then edit. So this will open this window. Here you need to just simply click on new and paste. Okay. So we are going to paste that extraction of the MongoDB shell path, bin path, and going to, you know, give it in our environment variable. That's one step. Next step is go back to our directory. I'll go back to C drive and I'll go to program files, and if you just simply scroll down, you'll be getting this MongoDB rightly installed. Okay, so that folder is rightly created over here. So let's go to that folder, then go inside our server, and this is, you know, our latest version, which is version 6.0. if you have previously installed Mongo, then you'll get that older version over here. I'll be recommending you to uninstall that older version and install the latest one. So you're no longer going to see that version over here. So just simply go inside that latest version, which is 6. And then you'll be getting that bin folder. So just simply go inside that bin folder. And now you need to just simply click on this address path and copy. Okay. Now minimize this and go back to our environment variables. Here you need to again click on new and again right click and paste. That's it basically. First we are pasting MongoDB shell and then we are pasting MongoDB. So these two environment path you need to set. This is a very important step. And now just simply click on OK. Then again OK. And then again OK. Okay. So let's minimize our download directory now. And remember, I have showed you about this service page. So it's going to create our Mongo. So let's click on M. Let's refresh this and see our MongoDB server is already started running. So for me, it's already started running. So if for your case, it's like not do not showing running. So what you can do is you can just simply restart your system. Okay. And it will going to show that it's already running. Since it is automatic, so it should be running automatically, and no need to, you know, start and stop this. Because all you need to do is just simply restarting your system, because it is already automatic. Okay, so most of the case it will be running only, no need to worry. Just in case if it's not running, then just simply restart your system. Okay, that's it. Now just simply close the service as well. And now let's open our command prompt, cmd, and let's check whether Mongo is correctly installed or not. So for that, just simply type mongod space dash dash version and hit enter, and there you go. See, our DB version 6.2.1 is rightly shown. So our Mongo is rightly created. Okay, now I'm going to show you about our Mongo shell. So for that, you need to go to your C drive, and you need to create a data folder. So let's right click and a new folder. Okay, so this is the place where all our data and database is going to be created. So let's create that DB folder over here, right? Data and DB. So this will be used by our Mongo shell. So now go back to our C drive again. I'll going to trigger our MongoDB shell. So go to MongoDB, our bin, and see, here is our MongoDB shell exe. So just simply double click on it to start our MongoDB shell. So if it shows something like this, so just, you need to click on more info and then just simply click on run anyway. And see, our MongoDB shell is rightly, started. So let's enter, and I can see that it has, rightly started. So, let's check all our DBs. Show DBs, hit enter, and you can see that we have admin, config, and local, databases already created by default. So let's, create a new database. So I'll be naming it as use players. So I'm going to, create a players directory, hit enter, and see, it has, rightly switched to DB players. Okay, so they have created a new database called players, and they have switched our control to players. Now, let's create our collection. So just simply type show, collection, and it's going to first show that no collections are there. Sorry, it will be collections. Hit enter. See, it is showing that it has no collection. So we need to create a collection in order to show that. So let's create a collection. So db dot create collection, and let's create our collection name as cricketers. Hit enter. So see, it is rightly prompted okay one. So that means it has created our collection. So if you click on show collection, you can see this time it is showing a collection called cricketers. Okay, so let's say you want to create another collection. So you just simply change cricketer to, let's say, footballer. Hit enter. It will going to create one more collection. So if you click go to show collection once again, hit enter, you can see that it has created two collections this time, cricketers and footballer. So inside these players DB, you can create many collections. So for now, I'm going to get insight to cricketers, and I'm going to insert some data over there. Okay, so for that, the command is db dot insert one. That's another update which is came on this version 6. So insert one, and then this is JSON. So you need to give this format, and let's give a player name called player name, and a colon, and a player name, let's say cricketer Sir Sachin, our god. Okay. Yeah, hit enter. Okay, so it is throwing some error. So why it's throwing some error? Because see, we have given just db dot insert one. We are directly using the method, but we have not identified that what collection we are going to use. So we are just directly using db dot insert one, which is totally wrong. We need to give the collection name. So db dot, so what collection currently we are? Cricketers, right? So you need to give that collection name. So see, db dot cricketers dot insert one. Okay, now just simply hit enter, and there you go. See, acknowledge true, so it has rightly inserted. Okay, so similar way you can insert one more. So let's this time insert Dhoni, and just simply hit enter, and there you go. See, This is also inserted. So now let's say you want to, you know, check your collection. So how we'll do that? So again, db dot your collection name dot find, and if you hit enter, you can see that it is currently showing, you know, our player name and Sachin, and also another player name which is Dhoni. So in this way you can do, you know, several things in MongoDB shell. So let's minimize this, and I'll going to, you know, jump into our MongoDB Compass. So if you come back to our desktop, you can see that our MongoDB Compass is rightly installed. So let's, you know, double click to open our Compass. So you can see that our Compass is rightly opened over here. So let's, you know, click on connect, and there you go. So see, it has connected to our local host, and this is our port number, totally fine. So just simply go back to our database tab and see, it has rightly created our players. So these players is what we have created in our MongoDB shell. Okay, this one. So what we have created in our MongoDB shell. So that player, see, that player DB is rightly created over here. So let's, if you want to create, you know, database over here, you need to just simply click on create database. You need to just simply give your database name, your collection name, and you can do this exactly same thing in our Compass as well. Okay. So this is basically, you know, the graphic user interface, or GUI you can say. So you can use both shell and Compass. Okay, so let's, you know, click on our players and see, remember we have created this cricketers footballer collection. So all those collections are rightly shown over here. So let's get inside our cricketers collection and see, we have created Sachin, Dhoni and all, remember. So that is also rightly showing. Now I'm going to show you how we can insert, you know, again, player name, let's say, on this GUI Compass. So for that, you need to click on this drop down. And see, you need to click on insert document. And it will going to open this insert collection dot cricketers over here. And you need to switch to this tab. And now you need to just, you know, simply see that ID is, unique ID is rightly created. You need to just simply click on plus. And here, just simply click on add field after ID. And let's give the, you know, column name, what, player name, right? And just simply give a tab, and just simply this time type any player name. I'm going to type UV. Just simply hit and insert, and see, it has rightly created. Now let's say you want to edit this, you know, so just simply click on this edit icon, and you can, you know, change this name easily. So Yuvraj, then just, you know, simply click on update, and there you go, see, our document is updated. Let's say you want to delete, you know, this column. So just simply click on delete, and just simply hit delete, and there you go, it has rightly deleted. So in this way you can easily, you know, do several, you know, this insert, update, deletion operation on this MongoDB Compass. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. I have rightly shown you how to install the latest version of MongoDB along with MongoDB shell and also, you know, MongoDB Compass. So that's basically all about this video. You know, do follow this video, and if you still have any, you know, issues, then please do drop a comment in our comment sections. I'll be happy to, you know, resolve your issues. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless.